This is Hikarigaoka Station on the Tokyo Metropolitan Subway Ōedo Line, located in Nerima, Tokyo. The Ōedo Line is a 40.7 kilometer, about 25.3 miles long line that starts from here, passes through central Tokyo, and returns to Tochomae Station. The section that encircles the city center is called the circular section, while the section from Hikarigaoka to Tochomae is called the radial section. The first section opened in December 1991, and the entire line opened in December 2000. In November 2002, as redevelopment of the surrounding area progressed, Shiodome Station opened, and the line took on its current form. The theme of this article is the Ōedo Line Extension Plan, which is 25 years since the entire line opened. And the starting point of this extension plan is here, Hikarigaoka. First, let's review the history of the Ōedo Line leading up to its opening and the changes in the extension plan. The current Ōedo Line route was more or less finalized in 1968. The Urban Transportation Council's report indicated this route would run from Shinjuku, passing through Kasugacho, Ueno, Fukagawa, and Tsukishima, towards Azabu. As the section east of Shinjuku was also considered as a circular line, part of the route is set to be reconsidered in the future. In the report of March 1972, the section east of Shinjuku was designated as a circular line, and further changes were made to add the section from Shinjuku to Takamatsu in Nerima Ward, and the section between Gokujiji and Nishiochi-ai, which was included on the route that is now the Yurekusho line. Apart from the branch line between Gokujiji and Nishiochi-ai, the section is nearly the same as the current Ōedo line. At that time, an extension beyond Takamatsu towards Oizumi in Nerima Ward was also considered, but no concrete progress was made on this. Plans for this new line were temporarily suspended in 1975 due to the oil shocks of the 1970s. The Shinjuku line, which was under construction at the time, opened in pieces, with facilities at each station omitted. But plans for the Ōedo line were not revived until around 10 years later, in the mid-1980s. The branch line section was removed in a 1985 report by the Transport Policy Council and was never realized. Construction of the radiating section began first, with the aim of meeting standards appropriate to the expected number of users, introducing new technology, and striving to reduce construction costs. The most effective way to reduce costs is to reduce civil engineering costs, which account for about half of the total. For this reason, the Ōedo line adopted a linear motor system. The railway motor is located in the bogie, which also houses the wheels, and because it has a rotating mechanism, it requires a certain amount of height under the floor. With a linear motor system, some of the motor components are replaced with components that fit between the rails. This component is called a reaction plate, and the force generated between it and electromagnets mounted on the car body is used to move the car. Linear means linear, and because linear motors are flatter than circular motors, they can be made smaller. While the only direct downsizing achieved by adopting a linear motor system is the underfloor area, the car body was also made smaller, making the train significantly more compact than the previous Shinjuku line cars. This made it possible to reduce the cross-sectional area of the tunnel, significantly reducing construction costs. The same is true for other domestic subways that use linear motors. So Japan's mini subways are characterized by their dual advantages of adopting linear motors and compact car bodies. Also, the shorter car bodies make it possible to make sharp curves, and the route almost never strays from under the road.
When passing under private land, there are restrictions on the size of buildings that can be constructed above ground, so compensation must usually be paid to the landowner, but if the line passes under a road, this burden is reduced. What I have explained so far also applies to plans for the extension section. The formation has also been reduced from 10 cars to 8, and compactness has also been emphasized in stations and other areas. The Hikarigawa-Nerima section opened in December 1991, the Nerima-Shinjuku section opened in December 1997, and the Shinjuku National Stadium section opened in April 2000. At that time, the name was changed from Line 12, which had been used since the original opening, to the Ōedo Line. The entire line opened in December 2000. Shiodome Station opened in 2001. The Ōedo Line is 25th anniversary since its full opening. As it runs deep underground, construction costs were high, with 400 billion yen, about $4 billion, for the radial section, and 960 billion yen, about $9.6 billion, for the circular section. The entire line cost 1,400 billion yen, about $14 billion. The cost per kilometer was 28.6 billion yen, about $290,000 for the radial section, and 32.3 billion yen, about $320,000 for the circular section. This far exceeded initial expectations, and with Japan in the midst of a recession at the time, there were concerns that the line would incur losses. However, Ōedo line ridership continued to rise steadily, with congestion reaching 178% in 2007. The following year, with the opening of the Tokyo Metro Fukushima line, congestion dropped to 152%. But until the pandemic began, it remained around 150 to 160. The number of riders has continued to increase steadily, and in fiscal 2016, the line achieved its first profit since opening. Today, the long line's length is also a positive factor, and the line generates the highest fare revenue of all four Toei subway lines. Meanwhile, during this time, the extension beyond Hikarigaoka remained untouched. The idea of extending the line first emerged in 1972, in recommendation number 15 of the Urban Transportation Council. In 1985, the Transport Policy Council's recommendation number 7 added the section from Hikarigaoka to Oizumi-Gakuen-cho. The change from concept to plan made the idea more realistic, and at this time, consideration was also given to extending the route from Oizumi-Gakuen-cho towards Nisa City in Saitama Prefecture. This route would pass between the Tobu Tojo line and the Seibu Ikebukuro line, helping to fill a gap in public transportation. 2 years after construction began on the Nerima Hikarigaoka section, in 1988, the Ōedo Line Extension Promotion Alliance was established, and local activity began to pick up steam. The Transport Policy Council's report number 18, published in 2000 when the Ōedo Line opened in its entirety, divided the extension route into two categories. The section between Hikarigaoka and Oizumi-Gakuen-cho was deemed appropriate for construction to begin by 2015, while the route toward the Musashino line was deemed appropriate for future development. The report also ranked routes into three categories, A1, A2, and B. A1, which is not listed here, refers to routes that were deemed appropriate for opening by 2015. Here is the list. All of the plans have been realized except for the extension of the Saitama Rapid Railway and the canceled extension of the KQ Kurihama line. Meanwhile, in A2, the Nippori Tonari liner has opened, and the quadrupling of the Tokyu Toyoka line has been partially completed, but nothing else has been done. While in B, construction has not yet begun on any of the plans, creating a big difference from A1. Then, in 2016, the Transport Policy Council published its report number 198. This report did not rank the plans based on the length of time it had taken, as had been the case in previous reports, but merely listed the significance and challenges of each plan. Regarding the section between Hikarigaoka and Oizumi-Gakuen-cho, it stated that road construction that could serve as a potential introduction space is progressing, and agreement should be reached between local governments, railway operators, etc., on how costs should be shared in order to commercialize the project. Although the terminus beyond Oizumi-Gakuen-cho was set to be Hikarigaoka Station on the Musashino line, the report states, "There are issues with the feasibility of the project, and we hope that the relevant local governments will advance the necessary line-side development initiatives to ensure feasibility, and then fully consider the project plan, including the project owner. This means that the project is considered difficult to implement. The latter route has less urbanization than the surrounding area, and since the line enters Saitama Prefecture beyond Oizumi-Gakuen-cho, it is likely to take time and effort to negotiate with the relevant local governments. And since the Ōedo line is a Tokyo metropolitan subway, its basic policy is to remain within Tokyo. The only Toei subway route outside Tokyo is Moto Yawata Station on the Shinjuku line, which is in Chiba Prefecture. Since the next station is in Tokyo, the line cannot be used solely within Chiba Prefecture. The extension of the Ōedo line is quite different in nature. Furthermore, in Nisa City, which passes through on the way, the railway line is concentrated on the north and south sides of the city, with development of the central area underdeveloped. Having intermediate stations would be desirable for development along the line, and plans are being proposed that include the location of such stations. However, in this case, there will be people who use the Ōedo line to travel only within Saitama Prefecture. The conflicting interests are more complicated than with the Shinjuku line, and it seems likely that reaching a consensus will be difficult. More than 30 years after the first section of the Ōedo line opened, and nearly 25 years since the entire line opened, the extension has yet to be realized, but preparations are underway behind the scenes. And did you know that some of the facilities for the extension have already been completed? They are located just beyond Hikarigaoka Station, where I was at the beginning of this video. When trains arrive at the station, they open their doors, let passengers off, and continue on. Because there are no tracks connecting the inbound and outbound lines just before Hikarigaoka Station, the train does not turn around directly here. Up ahead is Takamatsu Depot on the Ōedo line. This depot was opened when the first section of the line opened and is located southwest of Hikarigaoka Station. There is a section of the tracks connecting the station and the depot with almost no curves or gradients where trains turn around.
Turning back trains turn right as they leave the station. Meanwhile, if you look at a close-up video from a train arriving at this station, you can see the tracks continuing straight after leaving the station. These tracks appear to drop in height in the background. Here is the relative positions of the tracks. The number of tracks leaving the station has increased to 4. The two on either side were built with extension in mind, and the track on the south side extends to just where it intersects with the track leading to the depot. If a future extension were decided, it would be difficult to build a new tunnel under the tracks leading to the depot, so they were built as a single unit. Meanwhile, the tracks on the north side do not intersect with the tracks leading to the depot, so they end a little ways before that. Although there are tracks and overhead wires here, there are no reaction plates between the rails, so trains cannot run on them. The rail surfaces are also dull, indicating that trains cannot pass through. On the back wall, there is an illustration of an Ōedo line train. The details of why there are rails and overhead wires in an area that will not be used for the time being are unknown. From here, I'll take a look at the extended section and local efforts in preparation for the extension. The line up to Oizumi-Gakuen-cho is planned to be built directly underneath the road, with three stations planned. Approximately 3.2 kilometers, about 2 miles, of road has been developed in advance of the Ōedo line extension. Of this, 1,100 meters, about 330 feet, including Doshita Station, has already been completed. Land acquisition for the next 850 meters, about 2,800 feet, is 96% complete, and for the next 1,250 meters, about 800 feet, is 73% complete, so the project is progressing steadily.
Running the Ōedo line under private land would incur high compensation costs, but if a road is in place beforehand, compensation would not be necessary. Because road construction costs are not included in the Ōedo line's construction costs, they can be kept low, increasing cost effectiveness and making it easier to persuade stakeholders. This is the road construction that can serve as an introduction space, mentioned in report number 18, published in 2000. After leaving Hikarigaoka Station, you'll travel through the middle of the housing complex for a while. While the tracks heading to the depot extend south, the extension route heads northwest. From here onwards, this section opened in November 2013. The sidewalks are wide, with separate lanes for bicycles and pedestrians, making it safe. And the space that serves as the station plaza at Doshita Station was already developed as part of the land readjustment project. The space in front of Doshita Station is approximately 40 meters, about 130 feet north to south, and 80 meters, about 260 feet east to west, located south of the road on the planned site, and has been designated a transportation plaza in the land readjustment project. There is a sign here that was painted by local junior high school students to raise momentum for the extension of the Ōedo line. The road that enters the site near Hikarigaoka passes through the lot in a U-shape and emerges on the street on the other side. This road is hardly used, and when I stopped by, there was only one kindergarten shuttle bus on it. The bus stop is also on the street, but no regular buses come through. The lower part of the apartment building on the other side of the street has a clinic. The neighboring land is also intended for use as a station facility, and preparations for building a station are underway to promote the extension.
Even after the section developed in 2013 is finished, the secured land continues on and on. Oizumi-Machi Station is planned to be built just before the thick trees in the distance. There is a tunnel for the Tokyo Gaikan Expressway here, and the space above it has been designated as a transportation plaza in front of the station. Like the proposed site of Doshita Station, there is a sign here painted by local students. It's interesting how each location has its own unique character.
There is also land to the south, across a narrow road, and although it is not designated as a transportation plaza, it looks like the perfect place for some kind of facility. And further ahead, behind those thick trees, work is also underway to secure land for a road. It runs diagonally through the existing urban area, then turns left and continues to the proposed site of Oizumi-Gakuen-cho Station. The land acquisition rate is 73%, which shows considerable progress. Signs have been erected at the proposed site of Oizumi-Gakuen-cho Station, and nearby there is another sign with illustrations drawn by local students. Some of the signs appear to be standing on privately owned roadside land, perhaps to attract attention by placing them in a busy area, demonstrating Nerima Ward's enthusiasm. There are 6 of these signs in total around the proposed site of the new station along the line, and some people donated toward their installation. In the Oizumi-Gakuen-cho area, it is needed to go to Oizumi-Gakuen-cho Station on the Seibu Ikebukuro line before continuing on to the city center. Nerima Ward estimates that if the Ōedo line is extended, the travel time from the station area to Shinjuku Station will be reduced by 19 minutes to 31 minutes, and to Ikebukuro Station by 12 minutes to 30 minutes. It is estimated that the increased convenience provided by the extension will increase the population along the line by approximately 21,000, raising expectations for further development. In 2011, Nerima Ward established an extension promotion fund, and the total amount has since increased to 11 billion yen, about $70 million. In fiscal 2022, Tokyo Metropolitan Government included the cost of surveys related to extension for the first time, and in March 2023, it established a study project team. However, the biggest obstacle to realizing the project is still profitability. According to estimates released by the Tokyo Metropolitan Government's project team at the end of fiscal 2023, the project cost would be approximately 150 billion yen, about $1 billion. The extension section would be approximately 4 kilometers, about 2.5 miles, at 37.5 billion yen, about $240 million per kilometer. This is an extraordinary cost that exceeds the circular section's cost. 10 years earlier, in fiscal 2013, the estimate was around 60 to 70 billion yen, around $400 to $470 million. But due to rising construction costs in recent years, costs have skyrocketed. Unlike the circular section, which often passes underneath other lines, there will be no subway intersections in the extension section. The starting point, Hikarigaoka Station, is at the shallowest point on the Ōedo line, so construction should not be difficult, but it still costs this much. The target for railway businesses is to become profitable around 40 years after opening, which is difficult at current levels. As there are few houses along the line from Oizumi-Gakuen-cho onwards, there is apparently consideration of making the line elevated, but there does not seem to be any noticeable movement towards land readjustment or the like. Enthusiastic posters are lining the lines along the line, and in some places, progress is being made in securing concrete land, so keep an eye on the future of the Ōedo line extension. Thank you for watching.